In this video, I am going to introduce you to a few easy steps that will allow you to understand the basic principles of the main political ideologies in Europe. If you find one that appeals to you, then you should ask yourself, what are my political, social, and economic values? Which one matters the most to me, and which one I will want to advocate for? In order to do this, you should be very honest to yourself and find out what you already believe in by taking a famous test called Political Compass. The results of this test will guide you towards the ideology that best fits your inner values. As a young person, you have the civic right to vote and to adhere to a political party. Political responsibility is to be understood here as knowing what you are doing before voting or advocating for a political cause or joining a party or an interest group like Greenpeace. Your political choices as a young person will directly or indirectly impact your life and career, just like your diplomas and job experience. Your public support to a political cause will be added to your public image, so it is better to get informed before making choices. I am Bengüsü Erdoğan, and I have just graduated with a bachelor degree from the Faculty of Political Science at Istanbul Medeniyet University, the Department of International Relations, which is an interdisciplinary and extensive field. I graduated from the undergraduate program with a GPA of 3.15, and I was able to have a certificate of honor. I attended this department because I wanted to build up leadership skills and knowledge that I need to make an impact in my community and, I hope, at an international level. Days after graduation, I applied for a master's program and got offer to study climate change and international development in the UK. So my ambition for the future is to tackle this issue and its political and social impact on global society. If I think of a role model who empowered me and helped me find my inner power and motivation, I will say that it was my mother. She's an intelligent and ambitious person. She's had a huge impact on me while I was building my character and vision about the world. She told me that it doesn't matter what you wear or how you look, the only thing that matters is what you have in your mind and your soul. Thanks to her, I am a person who dignifies ideas and intentions but not material things. Thus, finding my purpose in life has become the most significant thing for me, and my personal fulfillment is closely connected to what I do in life. This is my key source of motivation. While I was a student, I knew that I should develop myself in many ways if I desired to establish a good career in the future. So I attended every free course that I could find. During the prep school, I studied Russian at İSMEK, which is a center that offers free courses for the public in Istanbul. I attended many seminars and workshops in several foundations, which have research centers about politics, economics, and history. Every museum in Istanbul has a Bergen Matini every week, so I made use of that opportunity. Besides, I visited free museums and joined every free event, such as the Istanbul Biennial, movie days, theaters, etc. Briefly, I try to attend every art event and academic workshop as far as possible. Besides, I try to participate in and organize all the events held at my school and in the dorm where I was staying. I led a humanitarian aid campaign at the university for children in underdeveloped countries. I performed in a couple of theater events and attended every charity event. Also, I tried to put into practice many ideas that I had while I had the opportunity to do so. Through all of these, I could improve my organization and leadership skills and build a strong network. Having this experience of activism, volunteering, and leadership has definitely helped me get accepted for the master's studies in the UK. When it comes to increasing employability chances, I was a bit late to get to this until last year. Now, I am a member of several communities which are relevant to the topic I desire to study for a master's degree. I attend every event of these communities as a volunteer and take part by translating news and articles. I am writing for a newsletter called Ekolojik Çatlak, which is an online journal published by Youth Center of Ecology Union as well. In addition to all this, I'm active on social media to influence and keep people informed on my personal social media account. Thus, I can build a good network and get experience, which allows me to increase my employability chances. An informed choice about politics means that you are given option to choose from, knowing the details, benefits, and risks of different political parties or ideologies. If you make an informed choice, you have investigated the positive and negative implications of the decision together with considering any alternatives. If you are making an uninformed choice, you are making a choice without knowing its full implications or about the alternatives open to you. Ethical leadership necessarily implies knowing your choices and presenting them to the other people that you work with or coordinate. In this video, I will present the main political ideologies in Europe and Turkey, so that you can make an informed decision about your potential political choices. Maybe you would like to enter politics, or maybe you have the right to vote and want to know more about an ideology before you give your vote to a party. If you want to enter politics, then you're preparing to be a young ethical leader. If you want to go to vote, then you're preparing to be a responsible citizen and maybe a future leader too. So we should answer the question, what is a political ideology? An ideology is a more or less coherent set of ideas that provides the basis for organized political action, whether it is intended to preserve, modify, or overthrow the existing system of power. All ideologies, therefore, have the following common features. They offer an account of existing order, usually in the form of a worldview. They advance a desired future, a vision of a good society. They explain how political change can and should be brought about, how to get from A to B. They provide individuals and groups with an intellectual map of how their society works, and more broadly with a general view of the world. First, I have to say that this is not a material that directly supports any political party or agenda of a party. It is meant only to raise awareness of some areas, the political spectrum in Europe and Turkey. So let's talk about main political ideologies. Liberalism is a defining feature of modern democracy, illustrated by the prevalence of the term liberal democracy as a way to describe countries with free and fair election, rule of law, and protected civil liberties. Liberal parties are based on the moral argument that ensuring the right of an individual person to life, liberty, and property is the highest goal of government. Consequently, liberals emphasize the well-being of the individual as the fundamental building block of a just political system. A political system characterized by unchecked power, such as monarchy or a dictatorship, cannot protect the life and liberty of its citizens. Therefore, the main concern of liberalism is to construct institutions that protect individual freedom by limiting and checking political power. Socialism is a populist economic and political system based on public ownership, also known as collective or common ownership, of the means of production. Those means include the machinery, tools, and factories used to produce goods that aim to directly satisfy human needs. Socialists take into account both individual needs and greater social needs. They allocate resources using central planning as in a command economy. Examples of greater social needs include transportation, defense, education, healthcare, and preservation of natural resources. Some also define the common goods as caring for those who can't directly contribute to production. Examples include the elderly, children, and their caretakers. Socialism doesn't reward people for being entrepreneurial, but struggles to be as innovative as a capitalistic society. A big disadvantage is that the government has a lot of power. This works as long as it represents the wishes of people, but government leaders can abuse this position and claim power for themselves. The five Nordic countries, Norway, Finland, Sweden, Denmark, Iceland, have strongly socialist systems, but these countries also incorporate many aspects of a capitalistic economy. Examples of socialist parties in Europe are Social Democratic Party of Germany, the French Socialist Party, the British Labour Party, the Italian Democratic Party, and the Spanish Socialist Workers' Party. Conservatism emphasizes the value of traditional institutions and practices. In Western culture, conservatives seek to preserve a range of institutions such as organized religion, parliamentary government, and proper rights. The European conservatives bring together parties committed to individual liberty, national sovereignty, parliamentary democracy, the rule of law, private property, low taxes, sound money, free trade, open competition, and the devolution of power. In terms of economic policy, the conservative parties are economically liberal, generally favoring the free market and opposing government's controls, positioning itself as the party of small business. The conservative parties advocate for low taxes, arguing that lower taxation will ultimately stimulate the wider economy. Examples of conservative parties are European People's Party, Alliance of European Conservatives and Reformists, and Alliance for Direct Democracy in Europe. The big three of liberalism, conservatism, and socialism has long defined the political outlook of the general public, intellectuals, and academic institutions. However, developments around the world confirm that another system of ideas has joined their ranks. Greens embody modernity's fourth political idea, environmentalism, which in its broad sense includes ecologism as a political movement and an idea. Environmentalism puts the relationship between humans and nature at the center of attention and is in fact more materialistic than the social paradigm. Climate change clearly damages the material interest of the poor, as the millions of climate refugees show. Environmentalism is not just an idea for the rich. At the same time, the environmental paradigm is not a class paradigm. It does not express in the manner of early liberalism the position of the aspiring bourgeoisie. It is neither the conservative reaction of a feudal upper class to bourgeoisie revolution, nor a working class ideology of struggle against capitalism. Sustainable living and business offer something to everyone. Sustainability stands for the universal elements of a good life, clean air, healthy food, sustainable development that should be accessible to all. The environmental approach is thus a universal one that reaches well beyond the globalist ideas of economic liberalism and free trade. Environmentalism, for its part, is concerned with problems that do not stop at national borders, such as radioactive fallout and greenhouse gas emissions. Alongside economic globalization, climate warming is ultimate global process. Its globality is why national populism has its head in the sand on environmental issues, especially climate. The admission of human responsibility would directly lead to solidarity beyond the borders of the nation state. Green politics or eco-politics is a political ideology that aims to foster an ecologically sustainable society rooted in environmentalism. Nonviolence, social justice, and grassroots democracy. It began taking shape in the Western world in the 1970s. Since then, green parties have developed and established themselves in many countries around the globe and have achieved some electoral success. The term political ecology is sometimes used in academic circles, but it has come to represent an interdisciplinary field of study as the academic discipline offers wide-ranging studies integrating ecological social sciences with political economy in topics such as degradation and marginalization, environmental conflict, conservation and control, and environmental identities and social movements. Supporters of green politics share many ideas with the conservation, environmental, feminist, and peace movements. In addition to democracy and ecological issues, green politics is concerned with civil liberties, social justice, and nonviolence. Green party platforms are largely considered left in the political spectrum. As the left-wing green political philosophy developed, there also came the separate existing, unrelated and polar opposite movements on the right wing that include ecological components such as eco-capitalism and green conservatism. In Turkey, green parties appeared and disappeared from the political arena, with the latest green party being established in 2020. Before you decide which political party or ideology you could choose, it is good to test your own values and ideas. Many of these values you carry inside you as a result of your education, the environment you grew up in, the family values, your readings, etc., and you may be not aware of them. The Political Compass is a website that uses responses to a set of 62 propositions to rate political ideology in a political spectrum with two axes, economic left-right and social authoritarian libertarian. The underlying theory of the political model used by Political Compass is that political ideology may be better measured along two separate independent axes. The economic axis measures one's opinion of how the economy should be run. Left is defined as the desire for the economy to be run by the state, while right is defined as the desire for the economy to be left to the devices of competing individuals and organizations. The other axis, authoritarian libertarian, measures one's political opinion in a social sense regarding the amount of personal freedom that one would allow, Libertarianism is defined as the belief that personal freedom should be maximized, while authoritarianism is defined as the belief that authority should be obeyed. This makes it possible to divide people into four quadrants: authoritarian left, authoritarian right, libertarian right, and libertarian left. However, the makers of the political compass say that the quadrants are not separate categories, but regions on a continuum. The political compass seems a universal measure of one's political ideas. It is not an election time survey, nor a shallow personality test. The test profiles are political personalities applicable to all democracies. The expanding range of features enables you to compare the politics of different countries and political figures past and present. The essential point is that left and right, although far from absolute, are essentially a measure of economics. A youth wing is a subsidiary, autonomous, or independently allied front of a larger political party that is formed in order to rely support for that organization from members and potential members of a younger age, as well as to focus on subjects and issues more widely relevant among that organization's youth. Youth wings may also be discussion forums for younger members and supporters of the organization to debate policy and ideology. The term youth wing is most often used to refer to the youth wings of political parties. In such youth wings, ranking or leading members are often seen as potential leaders or bureaucrats of the main political party. This has led to a perception of political party youth wings as being mere gateways of employment opportunity in the government bureaucracy for younger members, especially in the case of dominant or one-party systems where a party is ensured of victory at the polls. Political party youth wings mostly consist of young adults. The age requirement for most political party youth wings ranges between the minimum age of 15 years old to an upper age limit of 30 years old. In the end, what I would like you to remember from this video is that you should get informed about the ideologies and parties that exist in your country. It is better to understand your own values so that you pursue an ideology that you best relate to. And then you have two options: get involved directly by adhering to a party. All parties have a youth wing that accepts students and young adults. Or get involved indirectly by practicing leadership skills in organizations that mimic the political arena and are not affiliated with any political party. You could volunteer to learn or work with them as an exercise of politics without signing up for one specific party. Such programs for young people aim to build leadership skills, and some are organized by European Youth Parliament, European Solidarity Corps, Euroscala, Trans-European Policy Study Association.